all inputs multiplied by their weights, then added to a base term, bias term. So the function produces a straight line. This is what is very, very important. That means whenever you are doing this summation, it produces you a straight line. But the straight line we are taking with the help of what? Little bit linear algebra. We are going the straight line as what y equal to mx plus b. That is nothing but I'll show you this straight line. Yeah, this is the straight line. Let us see. This is the straight line y equal to mx plus b. M is the slope. And what is the b bias? Bias says that it is the path where it cuts the y-axis. So that is what I am going to talk about, the bias. What is this bias? Because this b, b is the bias. That is what I have added. What you are actually getting, you are actually getting xi into bi. Sum of what? Each input with its weights, you are getting x1 w1 plus x2 w2 plus x3 w3 plus xn wn. But you are adding this b. Why we need to add this b? Well, to get the more and more of linearity, I will show you this. The function of a straight line is represented by y equal to mx plus b, where m is the slope, where b is the y-intercept. That is what we know from intermediate maths. That is y is the intercept. The bias is the point on the y-axis. What is the bias? Bias says that it is where actually cut the y-axis, touches the y-axis. So the bias is that point on the y-axis. The advantage of bias is it allows you
sir. Hello, sir. Sir, Vijay Kumar, sir.
Sir, Vijay Kumar, sir. Cut time. Due to some technical error, speaker's system is logged off. Kindly be patient. Yes, speaker has been logged out. Kindly be patient.
Are maybe basic fundamentals of the line equation y equal to mx plus b, and the purpose of b, why b is there. So the same purpose here also we are keeping the b. So the major So still you are having any doubts, because mathematics, sometimes some people might be feeling that once I write an equation, it's difficult to understand. A simple mathematical equation, y equal to mx plus b. What is the purpose of b? You have to understand. Bias only influences the output values. It doesn't interact with the actual input data. That means slope is different from the bias. That is what you have to understand. Now, is one neuron enough to solve complex problems? Because I have shown you initially with one neuron, then I have shown you with a deep learning model with n number of layers, and each layer will have what? Multiple neurons. The perceptron is a linear function. Single perceptron gives me a linear function. Any perceptron is a linear function. This means that the trained neuron will produce a straight line that separates our data. This is now one perceptron produces for me one line that separates these data. That means red and blue I have to classify. Then I will try to draw a line with y equal to mx plus b. That is what the neuron does, because the threshold, it says this is the basic threshold. So this side it will say yes, this side it will say no, otherwise the other side it will say one, the other side it will say no. Now assume that you have got a data spread like this, red data is spread like this, and the blue data is here. If you draw one line, neuron one, here you see, if I draw with neuron one, then I cannot separate. That means error rate will be high. This side is red. If at all I say this side is blue, but even the red dots also will be present. So many red dots also will be present with the blue dots. So now what I have to do is I need to draw two lines. Forget about your neurons and everything. How to classify them? How to differentiate them with two lines? Try to understand like this only. How to differentiate them with two lines? So now I have drawn another line. This I am calling it as a neuron two line. So neuron, now I have got two lines. With these two lines, I could able to separate. That means when you compare this data, that is this slide data, when you compare this slide data, now you can try to, you will be knowing that the second slide data, this data is more complex when you compared with this data. With this data, you can easily separate with one line. But whereas this is complex data, you need to have two lines. Now let us see one more kind of data you have got. This is what I have shown. One line, it is, simple data. It is a little bit complex data. So to classify them, to distinguish them, what is the meaning of classification? It means to distinguish them, I need to have to draw two lines, and each neuron will give me a single line. So I need to have two neurons. Then a single perceptron works great with simple databases, with simple data sets. But whenever you need to, differentiate much more complex data, then you need to have multi-layer. So from this, the word multi-layer perceptron. That means each layer will have multiple perceptrons. So that is nothing but what? Multi-layer perceptron. Now assume this side here, you have got a more complex data, which is of triangular shape. Red dots are covering over, red dots are over blue stars. Red dots are over blue stars. This is more complicated data. Now how to separate this red dots against what blue means? Then again, you have to go maybe three lines. You have to go maybe a three lines. So that means now in this case, that means these lines will be in the shape of what? In the shape of what? These lines are in the shape of what? Triangulish. This means this is forming a triangulish. So that means you will be having a neuron one, hidden layer only one. You have got how many neurons? Neuron one, neuron two, neuron three, and you have got two inputs. Why two inputs? Because your inputs are red and green data, red and blue data. Otherwise, circular red dots are shown in terms of circular shape, and other one blue, or maybe I think so green, I think it's blue only. Blue are shown in terms of what? Star. So you need to have only data of maybe red, you can assume that dogs, and blue, you can assume them as cats. So you have got the blue and cat. So all of them are connected to three perceptrons, one, two, three. X1 is connected to perceptron one. X1 is also connected to perceptron two. X1 is also connected to perceptron three. X2 is also connected this. And this is the output layer. And these three are connected to this output. So this is also called as a fully connected one. Fully connected architecture. It is called fully connected. That means all inputs are connected to all neurons. There are two inputs. These two inputs are connected to, all the three neurons, and all the three neurons are connected to the output layer. We call it as a fully connected or some kind of mesh network in terms of what? Computer network. So this is what a small neural network I have shown you with a non-linear data. You got this thing. But sometimes data will be more and more complex. So So you need to go by a non-linearity. So how to achieve non-linearity? This is multi-layer perceptron. You have got maybe two inputs. How many layers you have got? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 layers, and each layer you have got six neurons. This is one of the model. A neural network model can have more than one neuron with more than one hidden layer. So many questions will be coming. How to select the number of neurons in each layer, and how to select the number of hidden layers, whether I should have one, or whether I should have two, whether I should have three, or whether I should have four, whether I should have five, or n number. How to choose this? That's a big question. I'll try to answer slowly. So activation function is also referred to as a transfer function or non-linearities. What is an activation function? Activation function is also called as a transfer function. Try to see, activation function is called as a transfer function. Whenever student, if at all he says, whenever student has given me with these weights I have calculated, then I will send to the activation function. If it is beyond 70, I will say above or equal to or beyond 70, then I will transfer that function, that weights as what pass. Otherwise, I will say it's a fail. That means activation function is also called as a transfer function. What they transform is the linear combination weights into non-linear models. That is the purpose of here, the activation function. What they do is the linear models, they will try to convert them or transfer them into non-linear models. Why we need to have non-linear models? Because sometimes data will be too complicated and you need to classify them, then definitely you need to have what? Non-linear model. Why to use activation function at all? Why can't you directly transfer whatever you receive? The purpose of the activation function is to introduce non-linearity. That is very, very important. Without it, a multi-layer perceptron will perform similar to a single perceptron, no matter how many layers we add. That means without activation function, deep learning network will act as a, or your neural network, or your multi-layer perceptron will act as a linear model, but it never becomes a non-linear model. And in fact, how many number of activation functions are there? There are infinite number of activation functions are there. Today, a lot of research is going on activation functions, but I will try to show you few of the activation functions and what are those things, how they are. Okay, now I'll take some time for doubts. Then if time permits, then I'll go to into this. Otherwise, it will take more time now. If answer is start this again, I need maybe 1 hour. So let us try to go with the doubts. So any doubts you are having? So doubts can be asked.
Or you web based? Or big data means the COVID-19.
Good morning, sir.
Hello, good morning, sir. Hello, good morning, sir.
Sir, Vijay, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Sir, how to train our neural network, sir, for a better output?
For a better output, training means you have to give more number of images and you have to adjust the weights. How to select the weight? There are also models that he function is there and other functions.
Hello? Hello?
Am I audible?
Audible, sir. Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Sir, thank you for the informative session. Can we have your PPT?
Yeah, that you ask the organizers, you know.
Okay, okay. Thank you, sir.
So I have thrown light on basically what is deep learning, you know, because I need another 2 to 3 hours to cover the remaining part. So here I am stopping. Any doubts, I would like to take care.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Can we know about gradient functions?
Yeah, gradient function. There are gradient functions, you know. I said error function, you know, you remember? I talked about error function. Whenever the prediction is low, whenever the prediction or error rate is high, then I have to adjust my weight.
Okay.
If the weight is around 6, for example, I have given for unit 1, the weight is 6. Made it to somewhere about 20 or 30, then what I am doing is I am adjusting my weight at a far distance. Then automatically what will happen is my prediction also will be oscillating. Previously it might be 40, it may go to some other percent. So what is the gradient descent is, it's a mechanism that will say how to alter these weights. There is a step function, and also gradient descent will guide me how to alter this weights. That means you try to adjust the weights of this at a low phase, or maybe try to adjust these weights at a high phase. So gradient descent function is useful because it works on the slope. That is the thing.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, can you explain about the long shutter memory? What is the role of long shutter memory in text classification in social media like Twitter and Facebook and all, sir?
What is that?
Suitable? LSTM.
Long?
Short-term memory. LSTM, one of the deep neural learning techniques.
Long, short memory.
Yeah.
No, I think so. It's a memory which will be there for a short time, but the capacity might be more. That might be.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Sir, can you please differentiate between neural networks and deep belief networks?
Neural networks and?
Deep belief networks.
Yeah, the neural networks and deep belief networks, complexity will be high. See, once I go high level of complexity, then differently, that means instead of 5 layers, if I go somewhere about 60 layers, and in each layer, if I go by what more number of neurons, then definitely I can classify better. That is only the difference, the complexity, in terms of complexity.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hello, sir. Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Very informative, sir. Thank you very much to Anurag University. We got today's session is very nice. Sir, my question is, multilayer perception is applicable only, it is either in the linear and non-linear data, sir. It is applicable for both or especially for non-linear?
Both. Because of the activation function, see, activation function I have not gone through. I mean, I have just given it. Because of activation function is there with each neuron, perceptron otherwise. So what activation function does is, it converts the linearity into, transforms the linearity into non-linearity. That is one thing. And the second thing is, the basic disadvantage with multi-layer perceptron in terms of, digital images is, we have to give images in terms of one-dimensional only. Multi-layer perceptron cannot take the inputs whenever it is in the two-dimensional format. So we have to give the images in terms of what? One-dimensional. And moreover, they are mostly fully connected. Multi-layer perceptrons are mostly fully, connected. Once it is fully connected, then the complexity is very high. That's why we go for into what? Other kind of networks. That is it.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Sir, as the number of layers in the network increases, so the cost also will increase, sir, or it will be it is good or bad, sir, to increase the number of layers, hidden layers inside the neural network?
Yeah, see, initially will increase. Later, you can also do the dropouts. So initially, I will try to have more number of hidden layers. And in each hidden layer, I will have maybe 10 to maybe I'll have somewhere about 64 to 512 neurons. So it's a bit complex. But later, what I will do is, if at all I am achieving a good accuracy, then what I will do is I will drop out some of the layers. It's something like this, you know. Initially, I wanted to do a project. I will hire 10 people, and I have to complete that project within 15 days. But with 10 people, I could able to do the project within a week. So next time, whenever I am getting a project of what 15 days, though I have got 10 people, I will only try to give that project to only 5%. Remaining 5%, I will allot to some other task. So this phenomena is called dropout. So though you have got 512 neurons, you may not be using all neurons. So those connections will be made as what neutral. So that means those neurons won't pass anything to other neurons. So you can say some of the neurons will be dropout, but your structure remains same. So you need not necessary to remove. Your structure remains same. Whenever you want, you can use.
Oh, okay, sir. Thank you, sir. This is Srinivas, sir. This is Srinivas.
Yeah, right.
Thank you, sir.
So in YouTube, a few participants have asked the question, sir. Shall I ask?
Yeah.
Can we take negative values as weights?
Can you take?
Negative values as weights.
Yes.
Negative values as weights, sir.
Weights, negative values, usually we won't take, madam, but anyway, you can give negative, nothing wrong.
Hello?
Okay.
You can take negative values, but how?
Okay, sir. So, one more question here.
Why are you talking about the night? They are talking about the night.
One second.
Yeah, please.
Okay, the next question asked is how to detect the object, which algorithm we have to apply in better way?
See, once you go with the deep learning, you need not necessarily to bother about what algorithm you have to do. You give the image, it itself will learn. The first hidden layer will try to detect what? Maybe the pattern. Second hidden layer will detect patterns within a pattern. Third hidden layer will try to detect patterns of second layer. Within that patterns, it will detect what? Micro. Initially, we'll be detecting macro, then macro to micro, micro to micro, micro to submicro, submicro to mini micros. The patterns will be detected like this, and based on that, it will try to this. But if at all you wanted to go for an image processing side, you are not using deep learning, you wanted to go with the machine learning means, you have to work hard on detecting what? This thing. But see, that depends upon the object, you know. If at all I wanted to recognize faces, I will use some other algorithm. If at all I wanted to detect means a car, I will use some other algorithm. So these things cannot be common, you know, for all the things. That is the thing. Detection. I am talking about detection. I am not talking about classification.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Hello, sir.
Yeah.
I want to know, in machine learning, we use a lot of feature engineering and everything, so that domain knowledge is also important.
Yeah.
But in a neural network, we don't need to do anything with feature engineering.
Yeah, yeah, that's true. That's what the task made very easily, you know, very easy. That's why even third year students and final year students with Keras and other things, they are using a deep learning model, which is already existing. There are several models of deep learning model, and they are able to classify.
Okay, then what is which one will be better, neural networks or machine learning? Because in machine learning, we use domain knowledge, but here there is no domain knowledge, like everyone can apply.
Which one is better, cell phone or ordinary phone of 20 years back for you?
Okay, you are comparing.
Now the technology, see, I said as a computer vision man who worked for 25 years in this field, but I always feel bad about the deep learning because nobody is learning the basics. But here you need not necessarily to learn the basics. Directly it will go. Once the MATLAB has come, directly once you say image means image will be formed. But when we have done, we used to create an image by with those data using C language. We used to write a program for creating the image also. So now with these packages, you need not necessarily to bother about. I mean, people will say those are all the small things, but people like me will say the fundamental things. So now with the deep learning, you don't require much of domain knowledge. That is true.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Hector?
Yeah.
So what is the exact difference between TensorFlow and then Keras?
The difference is only thing, number of hidden layers, number of neurons in each layer. You are only talking about these two. There are many. ReLU is there. Many is there. You put all those things at one place and you see. Then you will be seeing the difference only is what? Number of hidden layers, number of maybe neurons, and number of the other functions. And that is the thing. Whereas TensorFlow is a fully connected. Talking about artificial neural networks, they have got other functions like maybe they got convolution is there because they extract more number of features with the convolutions because they can have 16 to maybe 64 filters that are called as a convolution filters. And again, you'll be having pooling is there. Then you'll be having overwriting is there. So many features are being added to them. That's why I say that they are maybe much better.
Okay. Thank you. Are there any command to know exact one particular library's function? Suppose I want to know in hidden functions of TensorFlow, are there any command something instead of going description of TensorFlow?
I think so. There is no hidden command, but you can see the number of parameters.
Okay. Okay. That, can we get this through some command? Yes. Command line something?
By giving maybe with Keras and other things, once you say display means architecture, it will display what the number of parameters, but parameters you can calculate by looking physically also, by looking at the architecture.
Okay, thank you.
Participants, children.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. Sir, can I ask one question, sir?
Yeah, you are audible, please.
Yes, sir. Sir, we are taking here for weights every time randomly, sir. Is there any method, is there automatically to calculate every time trial and error and taking it will take a lot of time, no?
Yeah.
To evaluate this.
Yeah. There are things like HIST and other things are there. Neural networks will take from that. You can see, just Google it, how to ascertain weights in deep learning. Then you will be having various methods. How it takes, that will be given there. There are methods like HIST and other things. Usually it will be taken by them only. That is one of the popular ones.
Okay. Sir, my question, sir, this is the artificial neural networks, what you said. And deep learning. Then, what is the interlink between these two, sir?
Artificial.
Sir, ANN and DL, sir.
Deep learning. Both are same. See, artificial neural. See, thing is, whenever we say deep learning, artificial intelligence. Deep learning is a sub branch of artificial neural. Artificial intelligence and so on. Now, once I use the deep learning, you won't be seeing anywhere the component of artificial intelligence at all because it itself will do internally everything. Artificial neural networks, we use, sometimes I use deep learning method, sometimes I will see what artificial neural networks. So there won't be any difference. Artificial neural networks will use what the deep learning model otherwise.
I think both are same, sir, but depends on the layers what you have used.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you.
No, what you have to do is there are different types of deep learning models are available or artificial neural network models are available. You just see them. No need to think, keep your brain much. What will be their number of hidden layers you see, number of neurons you see. Then there is a comparison also available in the Google. and why is particular deep learning model is more powerful than this, they will be writing that. So now you can easily compare. Once there are more number of neurons, once there are more number of hidden layers, they say it is powerful. There may be convolutions are there. You try to understand what is a convolution, basically going to the image processing and other things.
Okay, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, good afternoon, sir. Am I audible to you? Sir, I have a question. When we are training a deep learning model, at the last layer, we are getting a particular class label as output. If we want, for example, for a particular piece of text or some image, we want to generate two or three labels. How can we do that, sir?
Yeah, two or three labels means your question might be this. Maybe input is a digit. I have to classify whether it is a digit 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 9. Am I right?
Not like that, sir. For example, I'm having a piece of text like some tweet. I want to classify it as, I'm having a movie review. I want to classify it as action, adventure, horror, humor, like that. I'm getting humor, horror, both. How can I do that, sir?
That means you are, you wanted to classify into five or six types, am I right?
Yes, sir. For a particular statement, there may be five types or for some other statement, it may have only two labels. For some other statement, it may have only three labels.
Yeah, based on the probabilities, you know, based on the probability distribution, you can do that. Because I say it is, I'll say saying that it is horror movie in class one, then I'll give the probability. Then I'll give you regression model, I'll go. Then I'll say that whatever may be, it is also having some comics or something. So based on the probability, how much percentage it is of... horror is there, how much is of comics are there, how much of what maybe some other things are there. Based on those things, you can evaluate. It gives that.
Oh,
no doubt.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Participants, still any questions, please?
Sir, I'm Sumitra here. Yeah. Can I ask you one question?
Yeah, please.
Yeah. So thanks a lot for that very interesting and informative session. Sir, when we are using this activation functions in this MLPs, finally, they will actually contribute towards increasing the accuracy of the classification process or the prediction process. Yeah. Is it so?
Yeah, definitely. That's what I said. That depends upon both the things, activation function and also weight adjustment.
Okay.
You can check any model. They will say usually you use ReLU or maybe some other thing, leaky ReLU. You can replace ReLU and you can use maybe softmax or other activation function and you can compare the result. Then you'll be, weights will be the same. Only you are doing what? Changing the activation function.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
These are hyperparameters are there, like width of the hidden layer, length of the hidden layer, number of hidden layers, number of neurons per hidden layer, and what type of activation functions are there. There is no hard and fast rule that these money are used, but only just trial and error methods.
There is no hard rule, you know. Nowadays, you know, nobody is designing their own deep learning model also, madam. There are 6 to 7 very popular models are there. People are testing with them only.
Okay.
Even people are not building their own. Already existing models are there. I don't want to name them, but you can go through Google. That is, people will go through the Google so that you will be knowing those models. So people are testing with them only.
Okay.
So that is the thing.
Suppose if we want to develop one...
you can develop using Keras or maybe Python with the help of that. You can develop. You can create...
Like what? For example, if in our college, particular college, developing IDs and all, for how, like, we have to develop facial recognition and all. So we have to train data with our college staff people, no?
Yeah.
then how can we use already developed models, trained models?
The trained models are available freely. You can give to them. See, trained model means what it will have. It will have only what the hidden layers and the output. Everything will be there. So your input, you are giving.
That is like only testing the data, no? But not training the model.
No, you that part also you have to do training, madam. Training means you have to feed all your images. Maybe in
okay, in their input, we have to give our input.
You maybe there are 1,000 faculty are there. So 1,000 is your training set.
Okay.
So what you have to give is first initially you give maybe give 800 images. Then give input as one from these 800 images. Then it should recognize. Then remaining 200 are there. Next time you give an image from that remaining 200, it should say that it is not recognized. So with your data itself, you say some of them, most of the 80% of the data you use training, and remaining 20% also you can use for testing. So that testing data should not be a training data. So that whenever you are giving a testing data, it should say it is not recognized.
So that means we don't need to bother about the code.
Yeah.
So whatever the code is available, we have to just replace our input data.
That code and you have to train.
Pardon, sir?
You have to, code is there, madam. Already you can go through Python or anything. That code is there, you can go through that. You just open the Python, then you'll be learning many things.
Okay. Thank you.
There, OpenCV is there. Our people are doing with MATLAB also. But I don't encourage MATLAB, though I worked a lot on MATLAB, but now we have got the open platform, so better you go with them.
Okay. OpenCV is better.
Yeah. Because that is open, no?
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Hello, sir.
Please, sir,
can deep learning be used with unsupervised data also, unsupervised mode of learning?
Yeah.
But the, what need to be done there in the supervised mode where we have labeled data there, we can easily apply it.
Yeah.
What changes need to be there if we have unlabeled data?
No, unlabeled data, because anyway, it derives features, you know, madam. For example, you have given 1,000 images of car.
Yes, sir.
You have given 1,000 images of dogs. You have given 1,000 images of horses, different dogs. Then what it does by learning, it will say, oh, these 1,000 belongs to one, because maybe comparing the leg size or maybe overall size, maybe face size and everything. So that means it will categorize these 1,000 as what one and those 1,000 as what other.
Okay, sir.
So whenever you use, then it automatically does.
Okay, sir. Because in one of the sessions, Jyoti sir said we don't need labeled data in case of deep learning.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. No need. Now here also it will learn itself.
Okay, sir.
Because if I say without labeling people, for people, it will be difficult to understand deep learning. So I have gone with the supervised, but with unsupervised also, assume that I have not labeled it as a dog. I have not labeled it as a horse. Can't you recognize that these two are different?
Yes, sir.
You will recognize, but you don't label it as a dog because you don't know that is a dog. You will say this is different from that is different.
Okay.
Maybe you are listening Tamil movie and also you are listening maybe Malayali movie.
Yeah.
But you don't know that is a Tamil, you don't know that is a Malayali. But after listening, what you will say? Oh, this is in some language, that is in some language.
Yes, sir.
No labeling, that is what. Madam, try to always think of what day-to-day examples. Then the concepts will be more clear.
Okay,
once
sir.
Once you are able to do, machine can easily do.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Sir, hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
These neural networks are useful for clustering also.
Yeah, you can go ahead. But you need to work on that. Because I cannot say no.
Okay.
I think so. It's over now because I've got other meeting. So any doubts you can mail.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Participants, still anybody having any doubts? Right. Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
But anyway, with short notice, I could able to.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. In this, speaker is main speaker is the note.
Yeah, no problem.
Right. Such case, you given very good help, sir. Thank you, sir. Your session is very informative. Most of the participants have given very good feedback, sir. And you started with the computer vision basics and what is the image and what is the importance of bias, what is the significance of bias, what is the significance of neural network, how to train, and everything you clarified with a simple example, sir. Even one of the comment, layman also easily can understand. One of the participants given that feedback. So yes, sir, your talk is easily and layman also can understand your all the concepts of deep learning and all. Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah, sir, thank you, Oblesh.
Sir, Vijay, sir.
All participants.
Mail ID, sir.
Yes, ma'am. I will forward, ma'am. All the participants, a small request is that already I sent a link for the code, previous sessions. Once you go through the groups, WhatsApp group and telecom group, access the code and try to execute that. Afternoon session, as usually, as per schedule, it will start by 2:30.
Hi, can you put that in the Google Drive or somewhere? I couldn't join the group. It said it was full.
Complete code, what I shared you, Google Drive, link only, ma'am.
Okay, thanks.
Sir, can you put PPTs also in that drive?
Yes, sir. Actually, Jyoti sir today is not connected.
No. Present current session, today's session PPT also.
Yes, these slides I will collect from the screen. I will forward to you, sir.
Okay, sir. No, please include in that Google Drive so that everyone will get, na?
Yes. That's what every slide, every day slides will be copied in a drive. That's what the link I share to you. Please.
Okay. Sir, thank you, sir.
Can you please again send the attendance link?
Sorry, sir, your voice is not clear. Anything else?
Sir, attendance link, please.
Yes, already shared you, no? One minute.
Can you again send it? Sir, please again send the link in chat box.
Yeah, wait 1 minute, sir. Wait.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
We will give enough time for filling your feedback, sir. No problem at all.
So feedback has been shared, kindly fill
up. Sir, full name of professor?
Dr. V. Vijay Kumar. I'm typing here. Yes. Sir, Vijay Kumar, sir. Vijay Kumar, sir. Yeah. All the participants. Yes, sir. With your permission, I will close the meeting, sir.
Yeah. Please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
All. Bye. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. All the participants, those who fill feedback, please leave the session.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your cooperation. Okay, thank you once again. Thank you all the participants. Fill the feedback and leave the session. Thank you. If it is over, I'm closing the meeting. Thank you.